Hello students, welcome back to Kiran's English Hub. So we are continuing with the summaries of 8th class English, and in this video we will be going with the next reading, that is The Earthen Goblet. That is a poem and it is of 6th unit, and the theme of this unit is art and culture. So here, The Earthen Goblet, this is written by Harindranath Chattopadhyay. So let us go through some of the life of Harindranath Chattopadhyayji. So he was born on 2nd April 1898 in Hyderabad in a Bengali Hindu Kulin Brahmin family to Algonath Chattopadhyay and Barada Sundari Devi. He was a multi-talented personality as an Indian English poet. So he was a multi-talented and was also an Indian English poet, a dramatist, an actor, a musician, and a member of the first Lok Sabha from Vijayawada constituency. So here we can understand all his life personalities, where he is a multi-talented. So in the field of music, in the field of writings, in the field of drama, in the field of politics. Okay, so he was everywhere in almost all the major personalities. Okay, the major fields. So he was the younger brother of Sarojini Naidu. Remember, you know Sarojini Naidu, right? So he was younger brother of Sarojini Naidu, the first woman president of Indian National Congress. Sarojini Naidu was the first president of Indian National Congress. And here, Harindranath Chattopadhyay was the younger brother of Sarojini Naidu. He is famous for poems like Noon and Shaper Shaped. So here we can, just with this small biography of Harindranath Chattopadhyaya, we can understand how talented he was and which fields he had worked, and his broad view. Like if he is working on a poetry or a poem, we can here immediately understand that he will have a different views on one single or one particular thing that he is about to write. So here he writes the poem which is titled as The Earthen Goblet. So you know all what is goblet, right? It is an object which is made of mud. It can be a cup, it can be a pot. Okay, so here in the first stanza we can see that the poet of this poem, Chattopadhyaya, tries to ask a question to the goblet here. So here we go. O silent goblet, red from head to heel, how did you feel when you were being twirled upon the potter's wheel before the potter gave you to the world? So now he is asking a question to the goblet, saying, O silent goblet, he says, hello, silent goblet, because the goblet doesn't speak, it doesn't have a sound, right? He says, red from head to heel, you are? From top to bottom, from head to the toe, you are completely red in color. And how did you feel when you were being twirled? And he is asking, how did you feel? Twirled in the sense, you know, just making something round and round. See, you see this, the round, the wheel, right? So the potters, while making the pots, what do they do is to twirl, okay? Just make this wheel to turn around. So that is twirled here. Upon the potter's wheel, upon the potter's wheel. So upon the potter's wheel, when this goblet was kept, he is asking, how did you feel when you were there? Before the potter gave you to the world. So before potter could give the goblet to the world. To the world in the sense to some people who comes and buys. So before he could be giving this potter to the people, how did this goblet feel when he was in the hands of this potter? That was the question asked by the poet. And now in the next three stanzas, we see the answer from the goblet. So once, you know, you must understand that the goblet is not so happy when he is in the hands of the potter. He doesn't want to leave the place, where he was before. So here the goblet is nothing but the clay, the mud, the red mud. It doesn't want to leave that place where it was before. So here we see, I felt a conscious impulse in my clay to break away from the great potter's hands that burned so warm. How did the goblet feel? He felt as though he was conscious, implus in my clay. He wants to just come out of that consciousness where it was so warm. He wanted to break away, in the sense, he wanted to escape from the hands of the potter, which were so warm. When the wheel is being twirled, this potter places the hand on the mud, on the clay, and tries to shape, the mud, the clay. And finally, it will be shaped into a cup or a bottle or a pot and all different things. So now, when that is being twirled, there will be the friction between the hands and the clay, and here there will be some warmness, warm feeling between the hands of the fingers of this potter and the clay. So here it is saying that the hands of the potter are burning. I felt a vast feeling of sorrow to be cast into my present form. So he's also saying that I feel so hard. I feel so sorrow. Okay, I feel so pain when I am being cast, in the sense, molded, changed into the present form. See, the present form of the goblet is this. So he doesn't want to be in this form. He feels so much of pain to be in this shape. He wanted to be in the previous shape. Okay, which was the clay, which was the form of clay. So now you can also see the sadness in the face of the goblet here, which is trying to speak to the poet. Okay. And next stanza. Before that fatal hour that saw me captive on the potter's wheel and cast me into his crimson goblet's step sleep, I used to feel the fragrant friendship of a little flower whose root was in my bosom buried deep. So he says, so before I could be shaped, or before I could be, captive into the hands of the potter, before I could be taken into the hands of the potter, I had a friendship with a little flower who was in my bosom in the sense on the chest. Okay, imagine you sleep and on your chest there is a flower. So this clay was, attached to the earth before it could be taken away. So at that time there was a flower which was also, felt to be a friend of this goblet. So, before that fatal hour, in the sense, the hour when it was on the potter's wheel. Okay, now the goblet says that was the fatal hour. Fatal hour in the sense, the time which is not so good. Fatal in the sense, like deadly. Okay, so before this incident, before I could be on this potter's wheel, I had a very good friendship with the flower. Was on my chest buried deep, who had a deep roots into my clay. And now the potter has drawn out the living breath of me, and now before this I was so happy having friendship with a flower, and now this potter has drawn the living breath of me. That means he is taking away the life from my body, is taking, drawing out the life from my body, and given me a form which is the death of me. And the form which he has given now is not so good. It is, as though it is a death. Okay, the goblet feels the present form, the form or the shape is not so good, and he feels that it is feeling as though it is a death shape, or it is a death of a goblet. My past unshapely natural state was best. Before this, I didn't have any shape. I was just, the part of the mud, part of the clay. I didn't have any shape, but it was the best shape. It was the shape which I liked. But now the shape which I have is not good, and I feel like it is death for me. With just one flower flaming through my breast. So before this present shape, the shape which I had, there was no shape at all, was the best shape, and there I had a flaming flower through my breast. Flaming in a sense like a bright flower, okay, which is a shining flower on my breast, and I felt you know, so happy when I was in that shape. Okay, when I was with the mud, along with the mud, and now when I'm into the potter's field, I don't feel so good. I feel it is the time of my death, and the potter is just removing all the life from my heart. Okay, so this is a small sort of conversation where there is a question and the other three stanzas express the feelings of the goblet here. Okay, students, so this is the poem for reading B here of unit 6. And in the next unit, I will be going with the reading C, which is Maestro with a Mission. Okay, so before leaving the video, don't forget to subscribe to get the further updates. So thank you for watching.